Hi guys, this is Christian for Bansi Cloud Tech, and today we'll complete the last session of the Kubernetes. So we will start from concept network. If you want to refer to the previous concept, you can refer back in the same series. You can refer the previous videos. So concepts, network, let's see, service. What is service? Service provides a method of exposing and consuming L4 pod network accessible resources. They use label sector to map groups of pods and pods to a cluster unique virtual IP. Ingress. An ingress controller is the primary method of exposing a cluster service, usually HTTP, to the outside world. These are load balancer or router that usually offer SSL termination name-based virtual hosting. So these are the concept. So service, we will go in depth. Service act as a unified method of accessing replicated pods. Four major service type are cluster IP, node port, load balancer, external name. So cluster IP exposes service on a strictly cluster internal IP, that is default. Node port service is exposed on each node's IP on a statistical defined port. Load balancer works in combination with a cloud provider to expose the service outside the cluster on a static external IP. External name used to reference endpoint outside the cluster by providing a static internal reference DNS name. So you can see the right side, the YAML file for the service. Sorry guys. So ingress controller deployed as a port to one or more host. Ingress controller are an external controller with multiple options, that is NGX, HAProxy, CONTOR, traffic. So specific feature and controller specific configuration is passed through annotation. So you can see the YAML file that is in the right side. Concept of the storage. Now let's guys comes to the storage concept of the Kubernetes. So we'll see in depth. There are few storage have like volume, persistent volume, persistent volume claim, storage class. So what is the volume? Storage that is tied to the pod lifecycle consumable by one or more container within the pod is called volume. So you got it right. So persistent volume, a persistent volume represents a storage resource. PVs are commonly linked to a backing storage resource, NFS, GCP, persistent disk, RBD, etc., and are provisioned ahead of time. Their lifecycle is handled independently from a pod. That is different. Persistent volume claim, a persistent volume claim is a request for storage that satisfies a set of requirements instead of mapping to a storage resource directly. Commonly used with dynamical provision storage. Storage class are an abstraction on top of external storage resource. This will include a provisioner configuration parameter as well as PV reclaim policy. You can see the volumes here in this YAML file. I have shared it. So these are the YAML file. You can see the for the volumes. So persistent volume YAML file you can see here. I have mentioned name, we have given PV NFS, storage I have given 500 GB, volume mode file system, access mode is read write many, persistent volume claim policy is recycle, storage class name is slow, mount option I have given hard, NFS server version also given, an NFS path I have given, and one of the server that is data. So PVs are a cluster wide, you can see here. PVs are a cluster-wide resource, not directly consumable by a pod. PV parameter, capacity, access mode, read-only many, read-write once, read-write many, retain, recycle, delete. So these are the pursuit volume reclaim policies. Persistent volume claims, you can see here, we have mentioned that persistent volume claim, name I have given my MNFS PVC, read-write mode, read-write many, storage I have given 500 gig, storage class is low. PVs are scoped to namespace, supports access mode like PVs. Uses resource request model similar to pods. Claims will consume storage from matching PVs or storage class based on storage class and selectors. So storage classes, we will use this. Uses an external system defined by the provision to dynamically consume and allocate storage. Storage class field is provisioners parameter reclaim policies. Okay, so that's all guys. We will come into the next video so that we can conclude. I couldn't complete in this video, so next video we'll definitely do it. Thank you guys. Cheers. Bye. Do like our channel, subscribe it, and put your comments so that we can know what you are thinking about us. Thank you. Cheers. Bye. In the next video, we'll concept configuration will cover. Bye.